Hey everybody, it's your boy Brickhouse here, and it's Friday. Just under a week from Thanksgiving. Man, how time has flown this year. Haven't done a Bud Light video in a while, but ran across this just yesterday. This is from the Post Millennial. Breaking! Bud Light paid $185,000 to Dylan Mulvaney for disastrous marketing campaign. In other words, this campaign cost Anheuser-Busch millions, and I mean millions of dollars. Steven Crowder revealed on Louder with Crowder on Thursday that beer brand Bud Light paid TikTok influencer Dylan Mulvaney $185,000. For the infamous marketing campaign, you know, the one where his face showed up on one of the cans of Bud Light. That campaign cost the company millions of dollars as beer drinkers revolted against the ad campaign and earned dollars elsewhere. So it happens.
You can bring this up. This is a document obtained by Mug Club Undercover. Shows that the figure is
man, pause does not work on this. But I'm gonna play this little video clip for you right now so you can see for yourselves.
This is an exclusive that was sent to us and we verified. You can bring this up. This is the document obtained by Mug Club Undercover shows that the figure is much higher.
Wow.
Dylan Mulvaney was paid. There was one deposit there of $185,000 paid by Bud Light. $185,000. Yes, another man being paid more than WNBA star players. I know you're thinking, but
that's true.
And here's the issue. If it would have been successful working in this industry, you don't pay $185,000 to an influencer if you don't plan to continue some kind of a campaign.
Right.
They were testing the waters. This would have become a national campaign if they thought it was going to work. This is an exclusive.
So there you have it. Now, again, that campaign in question happened way, 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 way back on April Fool's Day. Where Dylan Mulvaney posed with a can of beer with his image on the can on TikTok while wearing pearls and tiara. Mulvaney even drank the beer while reclining in the tub. Backlash was swift and furious as drinkers abandoned their beer in droves and turned to other brands like Modelo, who is now the number one beer brand in the United States. Mulvaney then posted videos and engaged in interviews talking about how painful it was to be the target of vitriol. Mulvaney recently won a quote-unquote Woman of the Year award from a gay magazine in the UK and has many other partnerships with KitchenAid, Kate Spade, and cosmetics brands among them. Mulvaney, who catapulted to stardom for documenting the transition to quote-unquote girlhood, TikTok became the face of many brands, only for conservatives to screaming from those brands. Bud Light, however, it was and is the biggest loser. Now, I will say, I haven't made a video on this in a while, but like Steven said, you don't pay an individual this much money unless you plan on making it a long-term campaign, marketing campaign, advertising campaign. And in this case, I gotta say, Dylan got paid, rightfully so. And Anheuser-Busch, on the other hand, well, they saw their market share drop, they saw their stock drop, they saw their market cap drop. And it has yet to, if it ever, will recover from this pain. So just thought I'd bring this one to your attention. Like I said, it's been a while since I've done one of these Bud Light videos. And comment down below. Tell me what you think. I'd be interested to see what you guys think about the large check that Dylan Mulvaney got from Anheuser-Busch for Bud Light campaign. While you're at it, please take the time to subscribe to the channel, smash that like button, share this video out there with your friends and family, and hit that notification bell so you don't miss any of my videos. And with that, thanks for watching. Later.